haven't been in the threads online related to the newest Fearless series, the Paladin, the Hire dual electrostat, plus a dual BA, the Roland dual electrostat, dual BA, and a dynamic. That's a triple hybrid, and the Lancelot dual electrostat plus six balanced armature drivers. So, the electrostats made me nervous how they were going to. Remember, when you're connecting drivers of different types, your crossovers are critical because they're always critical when using multiple drivers. When using different types of drivers, it becomes becomes really, really a gamble. You notice that they got a gold and like a sun symbol on this one. It looks gorgeous. I thought the other one looked gorgeous too. This one is just more, it's got that premium look, as it should, because it's, I believe, the flagship of the three. And since I had the measuring rig out, I decided to go ahead and graph it. This is expensive. It's got a lot of potential to go wrong. What does it look like? Put it up. Got a bass and a treble that are deviating from one another at the highest point of either one, about 2.5 dB maximum deviation. From the lowest point of the mids to the highest point of the treble, it looks like, quick judgment, maybe 8 dB. That's not bad at all. And also that hill climb from 1 to what is about 2.5 is really very, very reasonable. As a matter of fact, the entire plot and where it falls off, if you were to lay a Harman over the top of it, it would probably do quite well. Doesn't have any abnormal peaks or valleys along the treble. Sound impressions reflect that. That's why I went ahead and took the set I was going to review first, and within 10 minutes of having listened to these, thought, these sound not fucked up. Let me graph it. Looked at that and thought, oh, that sounds really good. Just for the record, let me see if I can go back. This is the La Hire. It actually looks very fearless in its tuning, which I was really pleased, because I thought, this sounds really good. It sounds like they did a good job. And it plots a lot like a lot of the stuff that they made before, and some of the ones that I actually enjoy, with maybe a little bit of the treble slightly toned down, which I think would be appealing to some people. Unless you're really into the intensity of the S8F, this would be something more along the S6 Pro, probably. And then we go to this one, and you've got even a just ever so slightly more taming, a little bit of elevation in the bass on this one, just a slight bump up there, and then the treble is, so on a graph, if you're looking at it, isn't it jumping out at you? And that was kind of confirmation of what I was doing while I was listening to it. There was nothing that was doing anything besides sounding really, really good. I'm going to start with one more From the Road by Lynyrd Skynyrd, because it's a live recording. It's a good live recording, and I'm extremely familiar with it. The beginning of the track, where he's listening to the audience, it sounds like it's like an encore moment, I imagine, because he's asking them what they want to hear, unless Lynyrd Skynyrd opened with that. I'm not really sure. The people on the left that are yelling out Freebird before he says, you know, what songs that you want to hear, sound nice, crisp, clear. Ronnie Van Zandt's voice sounds really nice and clear. And then the intro to the song, all the way up to where Ronnie does his first verse, just sounds really, really good. Excuse me. I'm so impressed with this company, and keep in mind that I've not wrecked either of the more expensive of the items. The S10 Genie, it's not something that I wreck, and the Hyper S is not something that I wreck either. So, but those seem almost like adventures to them, because they, on a basic level, they know what they're doing and do stuff really well, and then they try to experiment. I guess what any good company would do is try to see if you can get better. And sometimes that requires different ideas and different combinations of drivers, thinking outside the box. And this was kind of so much outside the box for me and my experience that I thought, here comes a chance for the third of the expensive Fearless to fall, in my personal opinion. And this, in fact, is the first to rise. It sounds really good. This song sounds excellent. The bass, the vocals, the minute details in the background, everything's coming through. I'm not really wanting for anything. This is Tupac, Ambitions as a Rider. Though the bass sounds slightly, the bass looks a little bit I guess I can catch it, but to look between this and the Lahire, it doesn't sound that much different. I actually like the way that this looks. I like the transition, I like the elevation more than I do on this, which is a little more tamed, but it's not playing out in an actual song. This bass sounds about as potent as the Lahire, so I don't think that there's any difference there that I can pick up. Like, oh, that's slamming, and oh, that looks a little... Not really. To separate the two of these and say one sounds better than the other is going to take me more time. I went ahead and went with this one because listening to the two of them, I thought, this sounds better, and I expected it not to because of my previous experience with their Bigger Money, which seemed like experiments. And I just expected to be like, okay, this is expensive. This follows the pattern, and I'm going to go ahead and focus on this one, and I'll get to this later. And then I actually flipped it, and this video is kind of proof of that. So I'm doing this video first because this was the one that I thought sounded more natural. That's hard to quantify, so I don't want to get into depths and heights and layering and all that bullshit, but it just sounds more natural. Why do you have to pay more fucking money to get better sound? You don't. Sometimes it works that way. This is the first instance with this company where they've got a series, because they've got several, where they seem to have actually done that. Where the one that's in the upper end actually sounds like it belongs there. Whereas I would have put the S8F at the top of that series, the S series. So this actually sounds like they tuned it to be the boss. And it sounds that way too. Looks gorgeous, it sounds really nice. Oh, no, wait a second. This is a track called Melissa by the Allman Brothers, and this has got the S, Melissa, repeatedly. There's times where you can pick up some sense of sibilance, and I'm not picking it up. The graph is not reflecting any particular, there is a spike at 8K, but it's not. The spikes at 8K are not a problem. It's when they are relative to what's before it and what's after it significant. And this really isn't a meat of the treble. Prior to it is within 3 dB or 1. It doesn't step up in an offensive way. And if that were to be a slightly recessed 8K, I realized in my OCD that hi-hat cymbal crashes are definitely going to be noticeably back and incomplete if 8K is cavitied. It's just going to happen. It can't be avoided. So the sibilant, the event that could happen on 8 or 9, it's not happening at all. Then this is the track that I would look for that. It sounds fantastic. Typical four-member band. Vocals and guitar sound awesome on this. I think those are the two things that a lot of stuff that don't have, like, scooped mids tend to sound really good. But here's where it got very interesting for me. And I can't say why, because I've looked at the stuff about electrostat drivers, and they don't seem like... They're not the same thing that go on headphones. However... This does sound clearer than a balance set or a dynamic set. And the only time I've had that happen was with the P1s, which are planar. These are not planar, and these are not electrostat in the full-size form, but they are giving me a resolution level that is superior to BAs only. Then this is the track. This sounds awesome on this set right here. I have not listened to it on the other set, so the Lahire might actually do the same thing, because they both do have dual electrostat drivers. I don't know, though, but this sounds really good. This is where I was thinking, is there any benefit, like clarity and resolution, to that taking care of the treble? It does, and this is the track where it's showing it. Most of the info seems to be in the lower end. This is pretty much a dark album, a dark track. But the stuff that's on the upper end, the distortion causes that haze that covers the entire track. Yeah, no, this sounds dope. Sounds really weird. They nailed it. It's so nice to do videos for companies that are improving. Like Cyberdyne robots getting better. This is the baseline for Taking It to the Streets by Doobie Brothers. I believe Michael McDonald was the singer on this track. Boom, 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 boom. The cymbals again, this is where something that has a recessed 8K, 9K region, that cymbal's gonna sound slightly back. On this set, it doesn't. It actually sounds right where it's supposed to be. So I can put up with that, but I prefer it to be kind of sounding like this, which is to say nothing is jumping at me. Vocals are not on my lap. Hi-hats are not giving me that edge of discomfort. Bass is not bloating into the mids. The mids are not something that I've got to strain to listen to. And this is the classic right here. Oh, I missed it. That cymbal strike is critical. And it sounds really good on this set. Piano, Steven Tyler's vocals, and that cymbal strike are all opportunities to mess up. And this is hitting all three of them quite well. It's not doing anything not good. And these are the videos that I hate the most because they're the most hard to digest for somebody that's watching it. Like, could you tell me the bad thing? I think for the price of this, I think the cable could be better. This is a typical Fearless cable that comes with their S series. If you're going to charge more money for something, and it is legitimately a superior item, it's got better resolution than the S series. The electrostatic drivers do in fact make a difference, and the bass is still taken care of by BAs like previously. I assume probably the same one. So this is in fact a step up. So why not step up the cable? So that would be a con in my book. If the beauty is again a level up, the technology and the execution is a level up, and the cable is the same thing. If you're gonna charge people this much money, make them feel like they're on another level by sourcing another cable and just including it with your expensive stuff. If you're going to charge over $800 for an IEM, give it a different type of cable just for the fuck of it. Because it's like showing respect to the customer. I can wreck this and say that this is in fact a great sounding IEM. It doesn't fail in the bass. It's not light. It's not heavy either. It's good. The mids are not overly recessed. The treble does not have any oddities. There's nothing expressed in my library that seems like it might be slightly an issue. Hi-hat strikes are great. They're not on the edge of being maybe offensive to people like that got the S8F and said that was a little too intense for me. This would not be that. But the cable, come on. You got to do better when you're charging this much money to people. And especially if somebody who's buying $300 set from you in the S series gets the same cable as somebody that's going to spend this much money. Got to reconsider that. I guess that's the growth of a company, but just to let you guys know. The overall experience is the overall experience, which means everything that's in it is considered, and that would be the overall impression. And I think that looking at the same cable that you get with a $350 set is not something people want to see. That's your son. They did really good. Nobody knew this company just a few months ago. Like a boss. Cable up. Cable that up a little. Make the people feel respected. I know you guys do good work. I've never talked to you personally. I listen to your gear. I think some of your adventures are a little kind of out into the forest, but if you make a bunch of great stuff, I think people kind of know that you want to take an adventure, you go that way. You finally made a set that's in the upper price range that sounds like it belongs there, and the only thing that you didn't do was change the cable. Maybe that's because I got a sample. I don't know. Slap something nicer in there with maybe a balanced termination on it, and you guys are good to go. And I'm out. That is a first initial review of the Lancelot. I'm gonna wreck it. I will do a full review, and also the Lahire will come up next. I switched this video up because I'm unprofessional. The Lahire will come. I think they sound really good. I just was just impressed with this and thought, why don't we go first with the showing it to the community? Lancelot. It looks, it sounds, and I'm gonna change the cable when I stop this video. And I'm out. And the video that I did previously, welcome to my world. I got more coming. If you thought that was like a rage video. I actually was swimming at the beach for a couple days in a row and felt so invigorated. And then thought the word community in this hobby is like a joke. It's not a community. It's a everybody for themselves. It's not a community. That's ridiculous. So that stuff will continue. And I'm out.